At this time, we ask you to please rise for our national anthem. Host for the evening, Mark Daniel.
Wow, 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 wow. Hello, everyone. Hello, 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 hello. Hello, hello, hello. Can you hear me now? Almost, we're getting there. There it is, can you hear me now? Perfect. Well, hello, and what a beautiful evening it is. We are gathered here on this very special night for one very special reason. To honor the invaluable contributions of those who have dedicated their lives to nursing and those who support nurses everywhere. Well, my name is Mark Daniel and I am delighted to be your host. You have no idea what an exciting evening we have planned for you and everyone watching virtually from home and all across the AdventHealth network of hospitals. Tonight, we come together to celebrate the remarkable achievements of those who have dedicated their lives to caring for others. And yes, I think you know I am talking about nurses. And give them a round of applause, yes. And I must let you know, and for nurses everywhere, Florence Nightingale has been our guiding light. Did you know that Florence Nightingale was born just 3 days from now, on May 12th, in the year 1820? She was a pioneer of modern nursing and became known as the Lady with the Lamp, because she would make the rounds caring for wounded soldiers at night, impacting their recovery by improving things like hygiene and living standards. But as a nurse, Florence Nightingale never stopped growing, evolving. In fact, she once said, "Let us never consider ourselves finished nurses. We must learn all our lives." And tonight, we honor her legacy by recognizing the nurses of AdventHealth who exemplify this spirit every day. They are the heart and soul of healthcare, providing comfort, healing, and hope to those in need. Tonight, we recognize the selfless dedication, compassion, and resilience of nurses who have gone above and beyond the call of duty. They are the unsung heroes who work tirelessly to ensure the well-being of their patients, often sacrificing their own needs for the sake of others. So, let us come together to show our appreciation and gratitude to these incredible individuals. Let us celebrate their courage, their strength, and their unwavering commitment to making a difference in the lives of others. So tonight, we honor you, the nurses of AdventHealth, for all that you do.
I was just like in shock that this is really happening in the hospital. I wasn't feeling so good, so we went to the hospital. They told me that I was going to be induced. My nurse, she asked me if we were married.
And she said I would have been tomorrow. You know, and we were like, what?
The baby had other plans.
One of the nurses comes out and says, do we do weddings here?
One of the nurses started running down the hallways like, there's gonna be a wedding, there's gonna be a wedding. So everyone just kind of jumped in on the idea. Somebody brought flowers.
And I thought to myself, there's no way she's getting married in a hospital gown. I was like, I will not let that happen.
She walked in with a bunch of blankets. So I'm like, oh, maybe she's just giving me blankets because it's cold in here. And she was like, do you mind if I make you a wedding dress out of bedding sheets? I showed her a picture of the dress that I wanted. And she has all these suture kits in her hand. And she just starts cutting everything up, sewing everything together with the sutures. And she did it within like 20 minutes. Like within like 30 minutes, we had a wedding ceremony, literally. Flowers, a wedding dress, like it was crazy. It was incredible the way everybody just comes together and they just drop everything for you. Like you feel like you're the only patient in the whole hospital. I had a wedding dress that I still have to this day and I'm going to keep. So this is little Landon, my first son. I know definitely if we do have more, I'm going back to Ivanhoe.
Wow. Now, friends, this story is just one incredible example of why we are here tonight, celebrating Nurses Week. But before we officially kick things off, I would like to invite Michelle Gold-Briquette to the stage, who will begin our evening in prayer. Come on up, Michelle. Thank you.
Thank you. Happy Nurses Week! Woo! If you feel comfortable, please bow your heads for me in prayer. Dear Lord, we come to you tonight with just a heart full of gratefulness. We are so grateful, Lord, for all of our nurses and the tremendous work they do every day. Lord, we are grateful for their spouses and their significant others and their families, those that support them and fill their cup every day and renew them so that they can come back and care for your children. Lord, we are grateful for this beautiful night that you have given us, for all of the team members that put in the work so that we could celebrate our team this evening. But most of all, Lord, we are grateful for you. We're grateful for your love and the mercy and grace that you give me every day, and the encouragement, Lord, and the peace and everything that you do to help us do this work. Lord, we ask for a blessing on our team members and everyone here tonight as they travel back to home. Please get them there safely. And continue, Lord, to bless all of our team as they administer care to our patients. Let their love and light shine through you. We pray these things, Lord, in your precious name. Amen. Now I would like to introduce our conductor, Richard Hickam.
Thank you very much, Michelle. Welcome, Richard. I like to shake your hand kind of like the maestro. All right, conducting all of us. Thank you very much. Okay, well, I just shook his hand and I'm very excited to introduce to you a man who truly believes in the healing power of music. Please welcome to the stage the founder and conductor of the Advent Health Orchestra, Maestro Richard Hickam. Oh.
Thank you, Mark. Appreciate that. Good evening, everyone. And for those joining us virtually, very exciting. My folks watching in Kansas, hey, good to see you. Well, actually, I'm not seeing you. You're seeing me. Tonight, I'm honored to introduce you to the Advent Health Orchestra, a group of talented musicians who bring the healing power of music to life. We've got a pretty amazing playlist lined up for you tonight. So sit back, relax, and let the music lift your spirits and soothe your soul.
The Advent Health Orchestra extends the healing ministry of Christ through music. We have an incredibly talented group of our own team members that have come together to form this group. it's been really fun for them to kind of rediscover a passion. Some of them have still been playing regularly, but a few of them dusted off the old violin and got it out of the closet and started practicing again and finding something they were very passionate about and wanted to rekindle that love, and now with team members in service of our community. During COVID, I just had an idea, what if maybe music could help us somehow to moving ahead? I have a background as a music teacher and an orchestra conductor, and I thought we could just figure out in this large organization here in the Central Florida area who plays what. I bet there's talent all over the place. We got together, and this really special thing happened. We quickly became a musical family. That first performance we recorded at the Dr. Phillips Center in 2021. Christmas 2022, we played at Disney Springs. It was well attended, well received, and to see new relationships form, I'm proud of them. I'm proud to be a part of this company that's allowing us to do something really unique and I think really special.
Courageous journeys. It's a theme that resonates deeply with nurses, mirroring Florence Nightingale's bold decision to enter a male-dominated field and pioneer healthcare reform. Like her, nurses embark on journeys of courage daily, navigating uncharted waters to provide compassionate care and healing. And tonight, we celebrate their fearless spirit and unwavering commitment to making a difference by welcoming to the stage one of our own, Dr. Audrey Gregory, Vice President and CEO of the AdventHealth East Florida Division. Right here, Dr. Gregory, come on over. Welcome.
Thank you. Okay.
Yes, it's a hot microphone.
It is.
Yes, indeed.
Very hot.
Now, Dr. Gregory, if you don't mind, you're my first person I'm going to be talking to this evening. And so I have a few questions for you, if that's okay.
That is okay.
Thank you very much.
Can I just say Happy Nurses Week?
There it is. Now, Dr. Gregory, your journey from clinician to esteemed leader of AdventHealth is nothing short of an incredible adventure. Your testimonial highlighted the courage and determination that have guided you throughout your career. How do you envision your journey inspiring individuals who are considering a career as an RN or those already in the field?
So I'll start a little bit with the testimonial and just say I'm a nurse by background. I am originally from Jamaica.
Yeah, I'm an island man myself.
So we just always chill. And so I think just as a nurse leader, I am one of those people who I think a lot about the team. I think a lot. I have the mind of an immigrant, so I always think about what does the patient need, what does the team member need, and how do I make sure that we're able to take care of families. And so that guides how I lead. And so for those who want to be a nurse, I will tell you the following. Difficult times are going to come. It's hard work. But I think it's important for people to understand that in the same way it takes a village to raise your kids, I think it's important to reach out for support. I think confidence goes a long way, and really being focused on the goal. For those who want to become registered nurse, it is the best profession out there, but I think it really takes focus.
Well, thank you. Those are wonderful pieces of advice. Now, in the movie franchise, Pirates of the Caribbean, or as we say in the islands, Caribbean, now, we know that it's known for tales of resilience, bravery, and exploration. How have these themes influenced your approach to leadership, especially in expanding services and implementing new initiatives within the AdventHealth East Florida Division?
I will tell you that every nurse knows that courage is important. I think at the beginning of every shift, you know that. And so I will tell you, as a person of color and a female and a mom, many challenges have come along the way. But I feel that there is much that I offer to the healthcare space. I think in our East Florida division, we have an incredible team, and that allows me to be the best of myself. They bring the best of themselves to work every day, and it allows us to be innovative, and it really allows us to lean into providing whole person care in our communities.
I like that idea. So let's dig into that a little deeper, along with the Pirates of the Caribbean theme. It is often associated with adventure on the high seas. So in your role as CEO, how do you steer the ship of the AdventHealth East Florida division through uncharted waters while staying true to your values and your vision?
I love that question. And I love that question because I love to cruise. So I definitely understand. I have been on cruises where things got a little rough.
Right.
And one of the things I've learned about cruising and just watching the ship's captain is that even when the waters are uncharted and rough, it's stay focused. Mm-hmm. You know what your goal is. You actually just focus on the goals and not the distractions that are around. And that can be said for healthcare. I think all of us as clinicians have come through the pandemic. That is something that was uncharted. We had no idea what to do. And I will tell you that nationally, AdventHealth is one of those organizations that excelled in how they took care of team members, in how they took care of patients. And so I think number one is focusing. I think the other thing too is that leaders, it's important when you're guiding the ship that you have, people talk a lot about resilience. I am more about fortitude because I think that is the mindset that it takes to go through difficult times. I think it's also important that you're adaptable. And I think as a leader, captain of a ship or uncharted waters, healthcare is changing every day. And so being adaptable is also going to be important. And then finally, I will say is it's an honor to be a clinician. You're invited in people's lives when they're most vulnerable. And so I see that as a gift. And it's a gift that I think every clinician understands. And we take that gift very seriously. And we love the honor that is given to us by serving our patients.
Well, thank you very much. I think that is a treasure of wisdom from you. Thank you very much, Dr. Gregory, Vice President and CEO of AdventHealth East Florida Division.
Thank you.
Tonight, we reflect on the battle for change. Inspired by Florence Nightingale's relentless efforts to improve unsanitary conditions and challenge the status quo of medical practice. Like Florence Nightingale, nurses today continue this battle, advocating for better healthcare practices and patient outcomes. And tonight, we honor their perseverance and commitment to driving that positive change. Please put your hands together for Rihanna Alanya, a senior nurse manager for AdventHealth Orlando. You are the maestro, Richard. So,
yeah.
Surprise! That was a rehearsal.
Perfect.
We'll take this microphone, and I'm going to turn it over, I believe, to you, Richard. Take it away. I'll be back. Thank you. wonderful. Tonight, we celebrate the battle for change by honoring your commitment to positive change. So, once again, please welcome back to the stage Senior Nurse Manager for Advent Health Orlando, Rihanna Alanya.
Yeah, it's like deja vu.
Yeah, it's like deja vu. Let's come right over here, Rihanna. So, Rihanna, I have a few questions for you, if that's okay.
Yeah.
And but you're doing a fantastic job, by the way. How about a round of applause
Thank
for
you.
Her? Just stepping right
good
out.
Good job, everybody.
Yeah. It's good. I'm glad you're sitting right there as well.
Make it easy.
It very easy. So, can you share a specific moment from your nursing experiences in hospitals that directly relates to the emotions or themes portrayed in the music you'll be introducing?
Starting with a really easy question, huh?
Yeah.
So I actually do have a story. It's a fairly personal story that hits close to home. I've worked as a nurse in a few different areas, and I previously worked in an area where we prepped patients for heart procedures. Most of the time they were scheduled, but sometimes they were emergent. Sometimes we had patients that came in with heart attacks. And I remember on this specific day, I was waiting to receive a phone call from the coordinator to understand our next patient, and I get a call, and the coordinator says, "Hey, Rihanna, we have a patient coming up to the cath lab. We need you to get them prepped. Their name should pop up on your screen in just a few minutes. I'm typing it in right now. They're having a heart attack. It's an emergency." So as he's typing in the name, thinking to myself, what are the things I need to get prepared? Where is my team? What tools do I have? And as the name popped up on the screen, all my plans went out the window. And I remember turning to my team, and they were able to step in and take over for me. And the reason that they took over was because that name that popped up on the screen, that was my dad. And he was having a heart attack and needed to go into the cath lab emergently. And as I think back on that moment and the day that the team took over for me, I just think about the action that went into that, the passion that they had behind their work. And looking back on that now, I just can think about the resilience that all of our healthcare professionals have when they do this job day in and day out. And so as we go into this next piece, you'll be able to see some of those themes, that action, that passion, and that resilience.
Wow. Thank you very much for sharing that personal story.
Of course.
Wow. And final question, with your deep involvement in the Advent Health Orchestra, how do you see music serving as a form of therapy for both patients and healthcare professionals in high-stress environments?
Good question. So I think that music can really be a tool that we can use in a positive way, especially in high stress environments. I think all of the healthcare providers here and people who have been patients understand what it's like to be in a high stress environment, especially in a hospital. And so I think we're really able to use our music and the power of music and use that in a way to heal our patients and also provide our professionals with just a little break and just a little reprieve in those moments of stress.
Well, thank you very much again.
My pleasure.
Another round of applause for Rihanna Alanya.
Hi, Orlando people.
All right. Can't wait to hear more from you. And as we do that, I would like to head it back over to the maestro.
Thank you.
Tonight, we celebrate the triumph of reform. It honors that arduous journey we all take anytime we set out to bring about a change we all know will make our world a better place. The triumph of reform embodies Florence Nightingale's groundbreaking work, which revolutionized healthcare and led to drastically improved survival rates. Her tireless efforts brought jubilations to countless lives saved. And tonight, we honor not only her legacy, but the legacy of nurses everywhere by recognizing their transformative power of reform and the profound impact you make in the world of healthcare each and every day. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chris DeBagas, a registered nurse, inpatient oncology, and PCO at Advent Health Orlando East.
A little teamwork getting me down here.
Yes,
thank
indeed.
You.
Chris, welcome.
Thank you.
If you don't mind,
Nurses Week.
Happy Nurses Week. How you feeling playing up here? What's it like right now? Outside, you hear it all. How you feeling?
It's incredible. Uh-huh. I always dreamed of doing something like this, and here it is.
Here it is. All right, now let's talk a little bit more about you, Chris. Now, your story begins in Massachusetts, where this song originates from. Can you tell us a little bit more about your journey to Orlando and how you came to your decision to become a nurse?
Sure. So I've been playing the flute since I was 9 in Massachusetts, New England, where I went to school, and all throughout high school and college. And then my husband and I have been in music ministry since right before we were married until we moved down here in 1995, and then all this time, I've been playing my flute at church, and then we have two children, ages 17 and 21, and when they were younger, I went back to school to become a nurse, and I did that to help support them and also to show them that you can do anything with Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, and He will strengthen you, and He will help you through anything. And the way I've grown so much and been able to share all this time through music and then grow in the nursing profession. Now I'm celebrating 10 years as a nurse.
Wow, 10 years, congratulations.
Thank you, all with Advent Health. Mm-hmm. And I'm doing that with my musical instrument in my hand.
Still
what
in your
better
hand.
Way to do that,
yeah,
right?
Definitely. And I'm sure your family's very proud of you. Now, considering the dedication you just mentioned and the time required to master one's crafts, what motivates you to pursue participation in an orchestra?
So it does take a lot of time and dedication, and I always dreamed of being in an orchestra someday. I always thought that whenever I would sit in a concert, my heart would just pound, and I'd be like, I can do that. I can do that someday. And I just don't know when that will be. I thought it would be sometime during retirement when I would have time to practice, but it was like God said, here it is, you can do this now. And it fit right in. And about a couple years ago when I joined the orchestra, I had the joy of working with all these coworkers to form this team, and it's been just incredible.
And like you said, teamwork, right? Very important. And finally, can you tell us a little bit about the piece that you're going to perform and how it resonates with you personally?
Sure. So I'm a New England girl, and I love the Boston Pops, and they're my favorite orchestra. So here in Florida, we only get to watch them on TV on the 4th of July whenever they come on, and my husband turns it up on the stereo and puts it all up in the backyard where we're watching the fireworks. And we turn that on 4th of July, but they're my favorite. And this song was written for them. So I'm really proud to play something that they play, and they do it well, and we do it pretty well.
All right, well, fantastic. Well, good luck and congratulations, Chris DeBagas.
Thank you.
Thank you. You want back up here? All right. Richard, how are you doing this evening?
I'm great. Hello, I'm great, Mark. Thank you so much. I just want to tell you about this next piece. that we're going to be playing and also welcoming once again all those online. So glad that you're still with us. So you may be in a different time zone. It's finally getting nice here in Orlando. When the sun went behind that building, it was a glorious thing, let me tell you. We had to warm up with the sun a little earlier, and now it's just absolutely incredible out, and it's going to get even better. The one thing I wanted to tell you about this next piece is that even though there's going to be a video on, there's going to be a lot of shenanigans happening in the orchestra. So keep your eyes out, peeled for Pop's Hoedown.
Thank you.
Wow. That was amazing. I know we had, did you all have fun with that song? But the real question is, orchestra, do you all have fun playing that song? Oh my goodness, that was so much fun. My favorite part is watching all the little sound effects that you hear in all the cartoons. You're actually doing it live, so that was fantastic. Thank you for leading us in the fun and silliness. But right now, I'd like to pause a moment and talk about the importance of leadership. Now, leadership is not just about guiding others. It's about taking action to drive positive change. Florence Nightingale certainly demonstrated leadership as she led her nursing team with confidence and determination, tending to soldiers during the Crimean War. And tonight, we celebrate the importance of leaders who also led by example, inspiring others to follow in their footsteps. It is my pleasure to welcome to the stage Sabrina Carlson, an RN at Advent Health for Children and a true leader whose actions speak louder than words. Her dedication and commitment to excellence serves as a beacon of inspiration to all of us. Come on over here, Sabrina, hang tight. I'll get you a microphone, because I would like to talk to you just a little bit. All right, right over here.
All right.
Thank you for joining us. Another round of applause for her, please. Thank you. So, Sabrina, I've got a few questions for you. How do you integrate your leadership skills into your role as a NICU nurse, and how does this influence the care you provide to your patients and their families?
Okay, well, I was born in a Christian family in a Christian home, so we obviously modeled our lifestyle over the Bible and specifically Jesus Christ, so I was raised with a very spirit leadership, or servant leadership, excuse me, kind of mentality. So some of the things that kind of goes along with that is leading by example, driving with empathy, other things like that, being able to personalize care. So I get to precept a lot on my unit, so I'm always orienting new nurses to the NICU. I work in the NICU with the babies, so I get to exude that a lot. Like, I'm constantly answering questions, trying to show them how to not just care for our little babies, but for the patient families, because they're the ones that are going to remember the trial that they're going through and need that support.
Wow, and that's something to think about. I didn't really think about that. That is true, you know, not just the baby, but it's also the families, because that's a big life change as well.
Yes, it is.
So I want to go back into your memory bank a little bit. Can you share a memorable experience from your time in the NICU that highlights the importance of leadership in nursing?
Oh, I'm not good at picking favorites or specifics. But anytime I'm in the NICU and I have to admit a fresh baby born at 22 weeks, weighing 1 pound, it's a very intense situation, or maybe we're coding a baby that's been with us for 3 or 4 months, that's when our leadership in the NICU really strives and for excellence. And it takes, like I said, empathy with the parents, lots of communication, and not just with closed loop communication, which we're all familiar with, but listening to those around you, because you might not be thinking of something that someone else might have a good input. Teamwork, lots of teamwork in the NICU. We obviously have our own assignments of babies to take care of, but we're constantly going in to help each other out. And I think those are the biggest things with leadership that not only I get to play a part in, but everybody shares that role.
Wow, thank you. I have a question for you. Off the cuff, it's not in the script, but you just have to fill in the blank.
All right.
Okay? If I was in robes and I had a lightsaber, and I would say to you, may the blank be with you. Fill in the blank. May the blank be with you.
Force,
you are correct. Yes, indeed. So that means you might be a Star Wars fan.
A little bit.
All right, well, let me ask you a little Star Wars fan question, okay? In what ways do you draw inspiration from the characters and themes of Star Wars as you navigate the challenges and triumphs of your nursing career?
That's actually easier than you might think. The first thing I think of when I think of Star Wars is hope. All the main characters have to really practice hope, and not only practice it and believe in it, but they have to encourage others and get other people to join the rebellion or whatever and take part of that hope. So obviously that plays a part in nursing, and I get to practice at Advent Health, where it's not only all right, but it is encouraged to share our faith and our hope in the Lord Jesus Christ with our patients and their families. And even if they aren't of a religious faith, like, we can still provide hope by being there with them, extending a listening ear, and you'd be amazed at how much, even just that, not even taking the medical part out of it, that how much that can improve their days.
Wow, well, thank you. That makes a big difference. Thank you again. Once again, Sabrina Collison, an RN at Advent Health for Children. Thank you. And Maestro Richard, I'm going to send it back over to your magic.
Thank you.
Right now, Advent Health Orchestra is going to entertain us with a hero we've all come to love.
This will be a day long remembered. The Force is with you, Advent Health, and the circle is now complete. Join me, and with our combined strength, we can rule the healthcare industry forever.
That happened. I'm excited. All right, well, as you can see, we have the Sith Lord, Darth Vader, and a few of his henchmen, the 501st, and a few other Star Wars characters. So feel free, they will be in the back for photo ops if you would like them. So if you'd like a photo op with the Sith Lord himself and his 501st, feel free to head back there. And once again, thank you very much. Now, as we continue, I'd like to say hello to everyone out there watching and still enjoying our live stream wherever you are in the Advent Health Network and you at home. I want to say that, folks, nursing is not just about the challenges. It's also about the joy and laughter shared in caring for others. And tonight, we celebrate the lighter side of nursing, a sentiment surely shared by Florence Nightingale and her fellow nurses, and one absolutely shared by Shannon Porsona, a registered nurse at Advent Health, Winter Park. In her role, Shannon's infectious enthusiasm reminds us that laughter is truly the best medicine as she pushes the boundaries of healthcare in her own unique way. So right now, please welcome to the stage, Shannon Porsona. Hey, Shannon.
Oh, you're really tall.
Come on. I'm fantastic. Shannon, I didn't know that was you right there the whole time.
Oh.
On percussion, having fun.
Yeah.
All right. And, you know, we have our Star Wars characters here, so I just want to jump in really quick and say, during rehearsal, you were showing your fandom. You had your Battle Droid t-shirt on with the Roger Roger.
I did, yes.
And as a fan, I see the bow back there.
I do. And yeah, it's a Ahsoka bow. I got a twin right over there. Where
Another
are you, my
one?
Friend?
Yes. Yes, indeed. Ahsoka Tano, right?
Yes.
Fantastic. All right, so Shannon, I have a few questions for you, if you don't mind. How has your upbringing and family background influenced your decision to pursue nursing?
Well, I am a second-generation nurse. My mom was a nurse that immigrated from the Philippines over here to America. She actually worked for, back when it was Florida Hospital in 1991 up to 2016. And I was born just down the road at South. So I think I was just literally born into the field.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. My mom showed incredible joy and caring. She basically sent or supported a lot of our family back in the Philippines. She was the only one that immigrated from the Philippines to America. She was the youngest of eight. So I saw how she was able to support financially, our family members, bring them over here, and even send some of my cousins to college, which some also work here at Advent Health.
Okay.
So I think it just, like I said, I was just born into the field, and I couldn't be happier where I am now.
Wow, that is so wonderful. And shout out to your mom. Wow, that's fantastic. Now, as you introduce Linus and Lucy, a song synonymous with adventure and optimism from the Peanuts franchise, could you describe a moment in your nursing career where you felt the impact of your mom's legacy shaping your approach to patient care and embracing each day as a new adventure?
So I had a recent interaction with a patient. I was going in for my routine med pass, and he looked at me, and he's like, how do you keep a smile every single day? Like, you're so happy. And I wear a mask at work, so I asked him, how do you know that I'm smiling? And he said, it's just the way that you carry yourself. You're very different. And I think that just has to go with how my mom raised me. Her Filipino nickname was Joy, and so she definitely encapsulated what it meant to live a life full of joy. And so I try to give that to everybody that I come into contact with, and whether it's for 5 seconds, if I can brighten their day, forget any negativity that they've had, then I feel like I've done a good job for a bit.
Well, I think it truly does make a difference, right? That positive energy, truly. Ahsoka Tano would be proud of you. Yes, indeed. Now, final question here. Well, in the first half, the characters in the Peanuts often face challenges and learn important lessons. Will Lucy ever let Charlie Brown kick that football? So can you reflect on a challenging experience in your nursing journey and how you overcame it, drawing parallels to the resilience displayed by characters like Charlie Brown and his friends?
So I think the most challenging event that I've had was during nursing school. I wasn't even a nurse yet. So my mom actually passed of cancer in 2016. And it was the year or the semester right when I started nursing school. The first semester, I was fine. She was sick, you know, everything was okay. But then she passed the week before, was it Christmas, at the end of 2016. After that, terrible. I didn't have time to process my trauma. I didn't give enough time to really figure out or why I wanted to do this anymore. But by the grace of God, by the help of my friends, my family all over the world, and especially my nursing crew, they helped me remember exactly what I wanted to do, why I went to nursing in the first place, to honor my mom, but to spread a little bit more joy into every person that I come into contact with.
Well, thank you very much. All right. Well, it's time for your song. Thank you. So I'm going to send it back over to the maestro, Richard, for Linus and Lucy. Innovation is the spark that ignites revolutionary change. Florence Nightingale embodied this fiery passion for innovation, revolutionizing healthcare practices that continue to shape our world today. Her pioneering spirit inspires us to push boundaries and think differently. I'd like to invite Shannon back out to help me celebrate Florence Nightingale's contributions, because you're definitely someone who exemplifies this innovative spirit. So come on back out here, please, very much. All right. So Shannon, I'm gonna talk to you again a little bit. Now, I spoke to Sabrina, and she was also a Star Wars fan.
Yes.
Yes, indeed. So how does your love for music and fandoms like Star Wars intersect with your approach to nursing and the innovative patient care, and how does it influence your introduction of On Fire?
That's a loaded question.
It was a long one. I thought it was over. You see how
I kept going?
Yeah.
Well, when I think of music and Star Wars, why I love it so much is because a community. There's a lot of people here on this stage that shares my love for music, am I right? And a few more people who also love Star Wars. And so when it comes to nursing, I always think about how they say nursing is the backbone of a hospital, and that backbone wouldn't exist if we didn't have a really nice, tight-knit community within the nurses. We can could depend on each other. We can count on one another as we go off on our shift. When it comes to this song, On Fire, as you will see, us percussionists, we tend to be a little crazy, and this is definitely going to show how much of everyone plays a really important role in this song and how we collectively enjoy it together.
All right, we'll definitely watch for that. That's very interesting. It's nice to know what we're looking at as well as we get a little deeper into it. Now, can you share a personal anecdote where your passion for music and nursing converged to create a moment of healing or connection for one of just you or one of your patients?
Well, I had a patient before, didn't really like to talk at all, kept himself, took his medicine, yes, no answers. On my final day with him, when he was getting discharged, I happened to we have a jacket that also says Advent Health Orchestra, and he saw it, and he said, "Oh, you're in an orchestra, what do you play?" So I told him, "Oh, I just dabble in percussion over here." His eyes lit up so big and bright, and he told me how he used to serve in the United States Air Force Band back in the day. He was a trombone player, and we talked for 10, 15 minutes. Remember, he didn't talk other than yes and no questions to me prior to. So it was amazing to see this man open up just because he saw Advent Health Orchestra. I wouldn't have known that he loved music or that he served in the Air Force if it weren't for things like that. So I think finding opportunities where I can share my love and passion for something and bring it out to a patient and let them open up, those are memories that I will remember forever.
Definitely. Thank you for sharing that. And I want to kind of touch on the legacy of your mom. How does your experience growing up with a nurse as a mother inspire your dedication to providing compassionate, patient-centered care? And how does it relate to the peace you've chosen?
Another loaded question.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, when I think of my mom and how passionate she was in nursing, not just nursing, but just caring for people in general, whether it was in the hospital or outside in our church, she was very passionate. She was really on fire for
okay.
serving her yeah. community. And I mean, there you have it. It's connected to the song.
Right.
But just bringing a burning spirit for something that you truly enjoy and putting your all to bring joy to others.
Wow. Yeah. Well, thank you. I'm excited to hear the song. Thank you very much again. Shannon Parsona, a registered nurse at Advent Health Winter Park. Now, once again, before I turn it back over you to Richard, I want to remind everyone, I do believe we still have the Star Wars characters. We have one more speaker that I'm excited about that will be coming up here on stage. But I'm most excited, Richard, I'm not going to tell him what it is, but you want to stick around because we've got an amazing finale coming up. This performance will take your eyes to the sky. So you don't want to miss it. Stick around till the end. It's going to be an amazing performance that will be entertaining us from the skies and from here on stage. And with that, I turn it over to our maestro, Richard. nursing is a profession that illuminates in the darkest of times. Florence Nightingale was known as the Lady with the Lamp, not only because she brought light to the wounded in the night, but because she also lit the way for the future of nursing. Her legacy serves as a beacon of hope and inspiration, guiding us as we navigate the challenges of today and tomorrow. And tonight, we are honored to introduce to you Kathy Stankiewicz. She is someone who embodies the spirit of illumination and guidance. Please join me in welcoming Kathy as she guides and inspires us as we continue our journey in nursing. Welcome, Kathy.
Thank you, Mark. Let me start by saying thank you to you, Mark, to Richard, the orchestra, and the many people not on this stage who have worked behind the scenes and contributed to creating this amazing experience. This wonderful evening of events has brought art and passion together in such a brilliant way to honor our nurses here in the audience and those watching via live stream. In addition, I'd love to thank Michelle for her opening prayer, Dr. Gregory, Rihanna, Chris, Sabrina, and Shannon for their amazing stories that are truly inspiring. As importantly, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to all of our Advent Health nurses here in the audience and those joining us remotely from their respective communities. Congratulations. We have all recited the Nightingale Pledge when we first became nurses. One of the key elements of that pledge is commitment to do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession. As evidenced by the stories you've heard tonight and the actions you take continuously, every day you all are living to that commitment and demonstrating the extraordinary characteristics of nurses. We've heard about courage and determination, bravery and perseverance, transformative power and care, leadership, inspiration, and joy. These are powerful words for a very powerful profession. And our actions associated with these words are part of the legacy of care that is vital to the communities that we serve. Another key element from the Nightingale Pledge is a commitment to dedicate myself to devoted services for human welfare. Nursing transcends beyond bedside care within our hospital walls. It exemplifies the goodness of the human condition and spirit. It personifies the best benevolence of humanity. While I am an executive leader here at Advent Health, I am a nurse first. In my 30 years, I have witnessed many changes and innovations, challenges and advancements in our profession, and how we fulfill our promises to the Nightingale Pledge. Despite the changes and the challenges, as I look at this crowd and reflect upon my interactions with nurses across Advent Health, I am energized about the future of nursing as a profession and especially at Advent Health because of the innovations, advancement, courage, perseverance, and transformative care you provide to our patients and each other every day to extend the healing ministry of Christ. On behalf of all of our leaders at Advent Health, I want to thank each and every one of you for all you do and the nurses you are. It gives me great confidence and pride as a nurse, knowing that each one of you carries the lamp and lights the way. Happy Nurses Week.
Thank you very much, Kathy. Once again, a reminder that we do have Lord Vader back there and his 501st, if you'd like to take photos. Great photo opportunities. Now, tonight, we have paid tribute to the brave souls who have dedicated their lives to the noblest of causes, caring for others in their most vulnerable moments. From Florence Nightingale's pioneering spirit to the modern-day warriors on the front lines of healthcare, you embody the true essence of heroism. Every day, you stand as a beacon of hope and compassion, selflessly serving those in need. You are the unsung heroes who work tirelessly, often behind the scenes, to comfort, to uplift, to heal. Your hands are the hands that hold. Your hearts are the hearts that beat with empathy and kindness. You are all modern-day Florence Nightingales, shining brightly in a world that sometimes feels dark and uncertain. So tonight, we call on all nurses to continue to embody her spirit and let her legacy inspire you to become the very best versions of yourself. Never waver in your commitment to your patients or your profession. And remember that we should never consider ourselves finished nurses, and that we should always continue learning all our lives. Maestro?
Thank you. As we prepare to perform our final two numbers, which will go with no breaks, I'd first like to thank our amazing host, Mark Daniel. Thank you, Mark. I can't think of anyone better than you to host this special night. And now, as a final tribute to our nursing heroes, I invite you to turn your eyes to the night sky as the AdventHealth Orchestra plays our final two numbers. But first, I would also like to give my nursing shout out to my amazing wife, who is a critical care nurse, nurse anesthetist, Darlene. I have a daughter that's looking to go into nursing school as well. Love those nurses. The 12-hour shifts, not so much, but love the nurses. And now I'd like to invite, also coming up for our second song, will be my dear friend Alan Dela Cruz, also a nurse at AdventHealth, who will be performing a solo with the orchestra. And it's a song that we wrote. We're very proud. It's our theme, Light the Way. Ladies and gentlemen, one final time, the AdventHealth Orchestra.
Thank you.
Happy Nurses Week, everyone. Here we go.
Thank you all for joining us here tonight, and to all of you joining us virtually. Your presence on this special evening means the world to us as we came together to honor the incredible dedication and invaluable contributions of nurses within our Advent Health team. To our nurses, you are the heart and soul of our mission. Your unwavering commitment to administrating the healing power of Christ is an inspiration to all of us. We lift each and every one of you up and celebrate your tireless efforts and selfless services. And to our guests and supporters, and to everyone who made this evening possible, thank you for helping us recognize these extraordinary individuals. Your support fuels our mission of spreading love and compassion. May we all go forth in a spirit of gratitude and appreciation, and together continue to make a difference in the lives of others. Thank you. And may all be blessed. Good night.